Hi folks, this is Sean McCormick from Lightroom Blog. Welcome to the channel. In this video we're going to look at Tether. I'm going to show a few other little tools as well that I use when I'm tethering too. We're going to look at tethered shooting in this video. Tethered shooting literally means attaching a cable between the camera and the computer for direct control and immediate downloading. Here's my cable plugged into the computer, and here's the other end plugged into my Fujifilm X-T2. I'm using a tether tools cable with a jerk stop to prevent the socket getting accidentally yanked. I have done this before and bust a USB socket on an older camera. The point of tethering is to let you shoot from the camera. I'm set up here with a 360 degree turntable. Here's a shot done this way. It's just a test set to show you what can come in. So let's look at some of the other images in the set. It's just a test shoot. It's nothing particularly interesting. It's handy because you're at the computer and you can control the lights and the turntable from there. Once your product is in position, everything can be done from your desk. So how do you tether in Lightroom? Well, you go to the file menu and choose Tethered Capture and then Start Tethered Capture. Canon and Nikon cameras are supported natively, but for Fuji you will need to buy a plugin at the Adobe add-on site. There is a way to do it for free, but with less control, and we will look at that in another video. The Tether Captured settings has opened, so we'll give the session a name. I'll stick with product test from my previous session. You can segment by shots, which will create a subfolder that you can name in a dialog that appears after you're done with this one. Choose a naming template. I'm choosing my own date custom suffix one and using perfume test for custom text. Now we will choose the location the files will be stored. I'm going to change this to a folder called perfume test. I could add to a collection at this point, but I'm not going to. I've saved a metadata preset called Untitled Preset that I'm going to use for this. I'll add basic keywords, box and product, and then I'll click OK. The shot dialog appears from our segment option, and I'll call this one box and hit return. The tether modal dialog appears. In this case, it hasn't detected my camera, so I need to troubleshoot. I figured this might happen, so let's take a look at the steps that you need to take to fix it. First, I unplug and replug the cable from the back of the computer. No change. Next, I do the same from the camera end. No change. Now I turn the camera on and off. Finally, I close the tether dialog and reopen it. That's worked. I've two more options if it hadn't worked. Restart Lightroom, and worst case scenario, restart the computer. You probably need to do this at some stage, so it's a good idea to have seen it in action. Looking at the dialog, you see the folder name, the segment name, then you see the camera settings, which you can't change. You can change the develop settings, known as a default, or you can choose a preset. The best option is to take a shot, edit it, and then use the same as previous option to have them all match and look edited as soon as they come in. By pressing the button, we'll fire a shot. Hopefully both lights fire this time around. There we go. It's just a shot of a box. We'll do some edits. Pull back the highlights. We can use the transform tool as well. And now I select same as previous. The setup isn't quite right for this shot. It's just a test to show you tether. So we fire a second shot and we can see that our settings are applied from the previous shot. Notice that the new shot is appearing automatically. As soon as we fire the button and it loads, we will see the next shot. I have computer control over my lights from the EL Skyports app. So, let's turn on my front light. I'm just peering over to check that it's the right light that's changing. Yes, it is. So we fire another shot and we can see that it's a little bit darker than the previous shot. This is a part of the beauty of why I tether. I can fire the shot and control the light for where I'm sitting. Okay, I'm just going to grab my iPad here for a second. This is for the third part of the equation, which is the turntable. It doesn't have a desktop app, but it will run on iOS or Android. So I'm going to set it to turn 30 degrees, and I hit the turn right button and take another shot. So we can see that the box has moved. I'm going to do the same again, 30 degrees, and fire another shot. Now the lighting isn't set up to get accurate reflections on the actual turntable at the moment here. But you can see that by sitting at the computer, I can fire the camera, change the lights, and spin the turntable. So that is the advantage of tethering, and shows how you can tether in Lightroom. Folks, hope you enjoyed that. So you got to see some of the little tools that I'm working with as well, remotely controlling my lights and my turntable. So if you did like the video, please do hit the thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already. Please do share it with people on your social media if you liked it as well. Don't forget, if you hit the bell, you can also get notifications of new stuff that's coming up, which, as you've seen, has been pretty much every day. Now, it's actually really tiring doing it every day, but I will get a little bit of stuff out, and then I will probably ease off on the frequency as well, because it's really, really intense. I know the videos are only about 5 minutes long, but it takes 4 or 5 hours to actually make the video, believe it or not. Anyway, thanks for watching.